Welcome to the St. Brother Andre Graduation Ceremony, Class of 2021.
My name is Catherine Dunlop, Head of the English Department.
And my name is Mark Schuldeisz, Member of the Canadian World Studies Department. We are very happy to be your MCs for our 2021 Virtual Graduation Ceremony.
Please join us for the singing of O Canada and the reciting of the opening prayer and land acknowledgement.
We begin our prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Loving God, we thank you for all these students graduating from St. Brother Andre Catholic High School. You have blessed them during their years in school with wisdom, friendships, and skills. You continue to challenge them to make this world a better place because of what they have learned, both from their parents and teachers who have supported and encouraged them, and from each other as they worked and played together. Help them to look forward to their next steps, taking the hope that they nurtured in our school community and igniting hope in the communities they join. Give them faith and a sense of purpose in their next steps. Show them how to serve others in effective ways as our patron Saint Brother Andre did. And may they always be aware in everything they do, that they will find fulfillment in doing your will, that you will be with them always, that you will bring to completion the good work you have begun in them. Amen. Saint Brother Andre, pray for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We are gathered on the ancestral lands and waters of all Indigenous peoples who have left their footprints on Mother Earth before us. We respectfully acknowledge those who have walked on it, those who walk on it now, and future generations who have yet to walk upon it. We pray to the Creator for strength and wisdom that all may continue to serve as stewards of the earth.
We will now have greetings from Ms. Teresa Sibby, Senior Student Trustee, Ms. Mary Batista, Interim Director, Ms. Jennifer Sarna, Superintendent of Education, School Leadership, Ms. Michelle Miranda, Principal, Ms. Maggie Wallace and Ms. Yvonne Tu Herman, Catholic School Council co-chairs, as well as a special message to the first French immersion graduating class from Mr. Joseph Chow, Madame Deborah Ramcharan, and Madame Shireen Cameron.
Hello, graduating class of 2021. Our 4 years of high school are finally over, and I'm sure I speak for everyone when I say that this past year and a half during a pandemic has helped us grow in both appreciation and resiliency. I know our senior year is not what we expected it to be, with a virtual graduation ceremony, nonetheless a virtual goodbye. But let us remember how far we have already come and the obstacles we have already overcome during these trying times. So from the bottom of my heart, I would like to extend a sincere congratulations to all graduates for the determination and dedication you have shown these past 4 years. As you enter into this next chapter of your life, I challenge you to use the valuable lessons you have learned at your Catholic to make the world a better place. Though we may not be the first class to graduate during a pandemic, let's hope we're the last class. That being said, let's remain hopeful for a future of restoration and renewal. And remember, your Catholic will always be your home. Thank you and God bless.
Hello, graduates, proud parents and guardians, staff, families, and friends. My name is Mary Batista, and I am the Interim Director of Education for the York Catholic District School Board. It is my honor to congratulate today's high school graduates. High school graduation is such an important milestone in life, and it is without a doubt unfortunate that we find ourselves marking this occasion virtually instead of celebrating with one another the way we traditionally would have. Graduates, it's okay to be disappointed. I share in your disappointment, as do your teachers, administrators, and families who would have loved for you to mark this occasion with all of the traditional joyous graduation activities like prom, graduation masses, luncheons, and of course the traditional cap and gown graduation ceremony. However, don't let that diminish the many things you have achieved throughout your time in high school or prevent you from making the most of this celebration. Graduates, take a moment to think back to what you felt like when you started high school in grade 9. Were you excited, nervous, ready to get started and take on the world? Now think about the friends you made, the subjects you've studied, and an interest you discovered that you had previously never thought about. Think about the lessons you've learned, both inside and outside of the classroom. Think about the skills you've developed, the skills you are most proud of, the skills that make you unique. Think about the exams you studied for, the tests you've written, the presentations you've given, and the way you pivoted to online learning and found new ways to connect with your teachers and friends through technology. Graduates, you have accomplished a lot. You put forth your best efforts under considerable circumstances, and you have succeeded. You are graduating high school and now armed with your Ontario Secondary School diploma. The possibilities for your future are endless. Graduation is meant to be a cumulative occasion, not a single specific moment in time. It is an opportunity to pause and reflect on the person you've grown to be and to challenge yourself to figure out what kind of person you want to become. Today's graduation ceremony is somewhat bittersweet, but nonetheless, a truly joyous celebration. Graduates, you have proved yourself time and time again to be resilient and adaptable, and these traits have grown your character. You should be most proud of yourselves. Your teachers, families, friends, and all of us at the York Catholic District School Board are also proud of you. A school is much more than the brick and mortar building in which you study. It is the community you contribute to, the ideas you share with each other, and the culture you create. What I've seen of the class of 2021 is extraordinary. I am excited for the future. Remember, graduates, with God, all things are possible. I have every confidence that as we turn the corner in our communal fight against the pandemic, we will do so with more wisdom, compassion, and gratitude. The class of 2021 is not one that will take the little things for granted. It is a graduating class that will seize every opportunity to build a better world and live life to the fullest. This school year's success is the result of a team effort between students, teachers, support staff, administrators, parents, parishes, community partners, and beyond. I sincerely thank each and every member of our York Catholic community for their contributions in helping our high school graduates reach today's milestone. Congratulations to the class of 2021. Your best years are still ahead. Good luck and thank you.
Good evening, honored guests, parents, guardians, teachers, and students. On behalf of the York Catholic District School Board, I am honored to be here with you to say a few words to our 2021 Catholic Secondary School graduates. Of all of us gathered here tonight, not one predicted that this is how your graduation would unfold. I am guessing that everyone had a story already written, one that included hugs, crowds, family, friends, and a toss of your cap as your principal conferred your diploma on a stage for all to see. Well, it's my hope that you not only learned enough math, religion, history, and science to earn your diploma, but that you have also grasped that our life story rarely matches that which we have envisioned in our minds. And that is okay, because your graduation story, along with your experiences over the last 2 years of high school, are special and unique, and not at all what we expected when you started back in grade 9. As you move forward and gradually return to a life that matches your inner Instagram feed, never forget the lessons that you've learned in earning your diploma tonight. You've learned that life is precious and unpredictable. You've learned that you need to appreciate the small things, like that moment when we can laugh together without a mask or a screen between us. And know that you've lived a great story that you will be able to tell and retell many times over in the years to come. Across the world, all of the 2021 graduates are experiencing the same bittersweet feelings that you may have. But when compared to all the other year graduating class stories, yours will be as unique and special as you are. I figure that the 2021 graduates will tell the story of how their high school experience unfolded to the awe and amazement of their children, grandchildren, and anyone who will listen. Take your hard-earned diploma and keep writing your story, the one that you will share for years to come. Congratulations.
Good evening, honored guests, faculty members, parents, family members, and above all, graduates. This evening, we gather to celebrate your academic success and to honor your commitment, dedication, and hard work over the past 4 years of your Catholic high school experience. The pandemic forced learning to transform and for you to become much more independent. You experienced rapid change, including saying goodbye to your beloved principal, Mr. Moyo, and hello to me in February, your new principal, for those of you who still may not know. You faced challenges and new opportunities as you worked to complete your grade 12 year. You never gave up. You kept your spirits high, and you were courageous and determined to make it through. And in doing so, through the many leadership positions you held, you kept the spirits high of our entire school community. You represent the very first graduating class of French immersion students for the York Catholic District School Board. 35 of you today are graduating with a red seal on your diploma. You took a leap of faith, understanding learning spans beyond the physical classroom, and as such, are graduates of our schism programs. 27 of you are graduating having participated in our pre-AP and AP programs. And what we all have in common, what we can all take pride in, and what we can celebrate together today is the achievement of a high school diploma. Congratulations to all of you. It is a result of your perseverance and resiliency that you are here this evening. It is also as a result of your understanding that adulting is dirty work. so let me pause and tell you a story, borrowed from the writing of Robert Fulham, author of All I Really Need to Know I Learned in Kindergarten, who reflects on an instance as a teenager where he observed his mother washing the dishes. As I tell the story, I want you to think about its greater significance. Fulham reflects, "Anyone who has ever completed the task of doing the dishes is keenly aware of the gooey sediment left at the bottom of the sink in the strainer once the task of washing dishes is complete. It is composed of food particles, fat, and fiber, what Fulham refers to as dinner dandruff. He was 13, and he remembered watching his mother reach into the sink with her bare hands, and pick up that lethal gunk, dropping it into the garbage. To top that, Mom went further, delving into that garbage to look for a lost teaspoon. And she did it barehanded, a kind of mad courage. She found the spoon in a clump of coffee grounds, scrambled eggs left over from breakfast, as well as vegetable soup. He almost passed out when she handed it to him to rinse off. No teenager who wanted to live would have touched that without being armed with gloves, a face mask, and stainless steel tongs. I am sure we can all relate to the story so eloquently recanted by Fulham. The greater significance is that Fulham realized at the age of 13 that adulting is dirty work. A child can make excuses. A child can cover things up to get away with it. A child can pass the buck, avoiding work altogether. An adult cannot. An adult must roll up their sleeves and quite literally face life and life's challenges barehanded. Tonight is an opportunity for us to self-reflect and be proud of how far you have come and all that you have accomplished. You are definitely not the same person who entered our building in grade 9. You are wiser, smarter, adept at overcoming obstacles, and you have learned that challenges and setbacks do not define you. In essence, you have tackled the realities of especially your senior years barehanded. You have discovered that you have limitless potential to accomplish great things, even in the harshest of circumstances. You have learned how to put others first before yourself, donning disposable masks and using copious amounts of hand sanitizer, all of which demonstrated your adulting barehanded approach, the sacrifice of one for the good of all. Fulham's tale also reminds us to reflect on those who have contributed to your entry into adulthood. To your teachers and support staff, thank you for your exemplary leadership and care of our graduates, and for doing the impossible to support them during school closures and much uncertainty. Thank you for your commitment to their education and for your guidance and support of our graduates over their 4 years of high school. A special thank you to the graduation committee led by Mr. Flynn, who have worked tirelessly behind the scenes to put this ceremony together. Finally, graduates, as you watch this ceremony with your family, turn to your loved ones. Your parents and guardians are the ones who are your greatest example of love, compassion, and resilience, and yes, barehanded adulting. Tomorrow and in the days to come, be sure to articulate to them exactly what they mean to you and how much their guidance and support has impacted you. Graduates, as a Catholic community of faith tonight, we recognize an important milestone in your life, the completion of 4 years of your Catholic high school education. St. Francis Assisi reminds us, start by doing what is necessary, then what is possible, and suddenly you are doing the impossible. As Catholic graduates, may you lead and make decisions with integrity. May you always remember to empathize with the experience of others. May you always be a caring family member and responsible citizen, just as you have been for the last 4 years at St. Brother Andre. As you embark on your next life's journey, find God's voice in your life and be sure to always do with intention, even when fetching that spoon from the garbage or clearing the dinner dandruff. Remember what we saw in you. You are a child of God, and as such, you are a good person. You will experience ups and downs, no doubt, just as you have in the last 4 years. But if you listen to God's message to you and you are willing to roll up your sleeves and do that dirty work, you will be guided just as you have thus far. Graduates, thank you for your spirit of generosity and many contributions to SBA life. Reflect fondly on the school-wide initiatives that you have planned and participated in, like Terry Fox runs and food drives, retreats, and share life initiatives. Reflect fondly on how enriched your life was when you offered your gifts to debate teams, best buddies, sport, the school band, and mass. Reflect both on those technical skills you've acquired in your classrooms, but also on the soft intangibles unique to each classroom experience. To all our graduates, we are so proud of you and your achievements today and always. As you move on into the next chapter of your life, remember the lessons you have learned in the last 4 years. Be grateful for the many people who have stood behind you in support during your best times, your crazy times, and even those that may be questionable. Be sure to continue the practice of offering your gifts to the world and being generous, realizing that the joy we bring others through our service is actually our joy as well. Remember, success is not always linked to a mark or a salary. Especially during COVID, we learned it is about the people that bring us love and that are in our lives and the experience that we have with them. And finally, remember that the adult life you are entering into will be dirty. There will be difficult decisions. There will be tasks you do not want to complete. There will be late nights and times you want to pull out your hair, but there will be joyous times as well. Regardless, remember that adulting is hard work. So roll up your sleeves and go at it barehanded. Congratulations to the class of 2021. God bless.
SBA 2021 graduates, you made it. The SBA Catholic School Council sends you heartfelt greetings of congratulations. Graduating from high school is the result of years of hard work. Well done. C'est avec enthousiasme que le conseil des parents de SBA acquiert aussi la première classe de diplômés du programme d'immersion français. Félicitations à la classe de 2021. The SBA Catholic School Council is also excited to welcome the first graduating class of French immersion. Congratulations to the class of 2021. Graduates, you showed us your resilience, perseverance, and complete determination this past year. This unusual time demonstrated our interdependence on each other. We are stronger when we act together. You displayed incredible maturity while faced with several obstacles. You led the school by example and remained safe throughout this pandemic. The next time you feel that your actions do not matter, please remember how your collective actions this past year were significant and literally life-saving. As you enter your post-graduation paths, real-life challenges will continue to emerge. Climate change, social justice, and the pandemic are a few of the most complex problems facing our world today. High school was a stepping stone to prepare you to meet these challenges. Embrace this moment and seize it to propel you and our world to greater heights. The love you have for your community and the source of goodness you displayed this year sets you above and beyond your years. You are here for a reason. Let your soul move you toward your destination. Listen to your inner voice as you follow your dreams. As you forge ahead, what mountains will you climb? How will you make the post-quarantine world safer, kinder, stronger, and more livable? Think big, imagine big, and bring it all to life. This is your time, and this is your moment. Light up the sky with your love, energy, and incredible minds. Be bold, be adventurous, be the change, and always be yourself. Congratulations and bravo. L'avenir vous appartient. The future belongs to you. Maggie Wallace and Yvonne Tuherman, co-chairs, St. Brother Andre Catholic School Council 2020-2021.
Bonjour tout le monde. Premièrement, nous sommes tout fiers de vous et vos accomplissements. Pendant ces 4 années à Saint-Frère-André, nous avons partagé des expériences incroyables. Il y avait des bonnes et des mauvaises expériences, mais nous les avons tous vécues ensemble comme une communauté.
Ça fut un vrai plaisir de travailler avec vous. Nous sommes honorés d'être ici pour célébrer votre progrès à cet événement spécial. Vous avez ouvert la voie à notre programme Immersion française pour notre école et notre conseil scolaire.
Nous avons hâte de voir l'influence positive que votre passion aura sur notre communauté globale. Comprenons que le contexte, bien sûr, est votre guide ultime à la compassion. Rappelez-vous que la moyenne de vivre le bonheur est de cultiver votre jardin.
Attendre et espérer.
Hashtag Summer Vibes.
Souvenez que SBA est toujours un endroit où vous pouvez revenir. Félicitations.
Thank you to all those who brought greetings. And now, the time that we've all been waiting for, the conferral of diplomas. Thank you.
Congratulations, class of 2021. Well done.
We will now move on to present our board, school, and community awards. The first award of the evening is the Faith Leadership Award, which goes to Chrisanne Bautista and Luke Blomestein.
This year's Community Recognition Award goes to Geethan Baskaran.
The Town of Whitchurch Stouffville Student Award goes to Efia Ponia.
The recipient of the Michael Carnevale Award is McKenna Clapperton.
This year's Environmental Stewardship Award winner is Julia Oliveira.
The York Catholic Teacher Award goes to Patrick Ang.
The Carpe Diem Award winner is Julia Morelli.
The winner of the St. Brother Andre Award is James Rogers.
The Jessica Sajiba Award goes to Cassandra Riley.
The recipient of this year's Catholic School Council Award in honor of Mr. Dan DiRocco is Luke Blomestein.
The Catholic Student Award winner is Clement Say.
The Melton Moyo Equity, Diversity, and Inclusion Award goes to Miranda Jimenez.
This year's Rick Maloney Student Athlete Award winner is Tyrone Cunningham.
Our next series of awards are for student leadership. The Student Leadership Award for Student Council President goes to Victoria Sefton and Luke Blomestein.
The Student Leadership Award for Empowered Student Partnerships goes to Geethan Baskaran, for Faith Development Council, Chrisanne Bautista, and for Student Council, Patrick Ang.
The Student Leadership Award winner for Arts Council is Alexander Gain, for Athletic Council, Mark Bonner, for Luke 418, McKenna Clapperton, and for Power Source, Aisha Basu.
Principal's list recognizes the students with the top 10 academic averages in their grade 12 year. This year's recipients in alphabetical order are Patrick Ang, Geethan Baskaran, Alexander Gain, Mahir Gupta, Caitlin Lau, Nicholas Pedro, Efia Ponia, Victoria Sefton, Richard Ye, and Florence Yoon. The Principal's Award in honor of Mr. Blair Day, founding principal, goes to Victoria Sefton.
The Lieutenant Governor's Community Volunteer Award goes to Natan Satrakian.
The recipient of this year's Governor General's Award is Geethan Baskaran.
The Lincoln M. Alexander Award is presented to Alexis Ajay Jemera.
And now it's time for the valedictorian address to the class of 2021 from this year's valedictorians, Alexis Ajay Jemera and Aisha Basu.
And I have a feeling Alexis is going to be late.
Sis, where are you? Hello?
Hello?
Where are you? Do you know what time it is? Do you know what you're supposed to be doing?
Do you know what day it is?
What do you mean what day it is? Of course I know what day it is. It's like Tuesday.
The speech is starting in 30 seconds.
What?
Get ready right now.
The speech is starting when? Okay, I'm coming. I'm on my way. I'm coming. Don't even worry.
I'm here. I made it.
not feel like the usual morning at SBA. Good evening, parents, families, staff, honored guests, and the famous class of 2021. Welcome and bienvenue to SBA's first graduation to be hosted by the curling team. Thank you. I'm Alexis Adjamara.
And I'm Aisha Basu, and we're so excited to be here with you in your living room, kitchen, basement, backyard, or overseas vacation rental, just hopefully not your bathroom.
Tonight, we will attempt to take you through the ups and downs of being a student whose K-12 account ends with a 21, without breaking down, of course.
Well, it is recorded, so we could remove it.
That is true.
To start, I think we should recognize the first that make us the cool and unique class we are. Je veux reconnaître notre première classe d'immersion française être diplômée à notre école et dans le récit d'SB. De Cyrano à Candide, du contexte aux conversations à propos de l'avenir, tu vas nous manquer. Vos films nous ont terrifiés et vos conseils nous ont touchés. Durant ces 4 ans, on était plus qu'une communauté de francophones, on était une famille. Alors j'espère que chacun de vous n'oublierait jamais notre temps ensemble. Félicitations à tous ceux qui ont réussi à arriver à ce point. Et même ceux qui ne sont pas présents avec nous aujourd'hui, je suis certaine que notre père à l'école secondaire est fier de vous.
Bro, I have to be honest with you, I don't understand what you just said.
Well, I wouldn't worry too much, because I don't think the French department does either.
As I'm sure you noticed, we are also the first class to make it through a full year of online learning, and the first and hopefully last class to graduate online. It's wild to think that some of us have not set foot in a school we once called our home away from home for a whole year. This was probably not the educational experience we thought we would receive, but it's taught us more than we could have ever imagined.
Hey, Alexis, did you know that our graduating class is also making history tonight by having SBA's first Black valedictorian in all of its 37 years?
Really? Well, I'm glad to go first. Progress would have had to come sometime.
That's true. And achieving these many firsts with all of you is what makes us special. Imagine our entire high school career as a single day at SBA with a lunch, the best lunch. Let's look at grade 9 as our first period. I still remember our first day at school. Every one of us walked into SBA with our new quirky uniforms, cautiously looking around at the people we'd spend the next 4 years with.
You walked in as people who didn't know their potential. I'm talking about potential friends, teachers, grades, and even potential failed relationships. Like many failed relationships. But you know what? I wasn't a part of the original class, but through conversations with the majority of you, I realized that one of your greatest freshman moments as a collective group was Muskoka. Muskoka gave you all the opportunity to feel like a family.
That's so true. We entered the woods not knowing what separated us.
But only the factor of what brought you together. Freshman year was a foundation, and we were only looking up from there.
And by up, we mean second period, or the 10th grade. In all of our different streams, whether applied, academic, AP, or locally developed, we started to find ourselves in our interests, friends, and even teachers. But no matter what our pathways, we were all united in exploring events and activities like homecoming, our first awards night, student government talent shows, the highly unforgettable semi-formal, and the surprisingly forgettable OSSLT.
Ah, OSSLT, what a tragic time. But hey, OSSLT was a good reminder that there would always be a test to let us know that our reading and comprehension was not where it needed to be. But you know what, Aisha? I feel like nothing brought us together. I mean, like nothing brought us together more than open classes. See, these open courses allowed for quiet students to be the roaring voices in civics and for the well-known personality to tell you in a quiet whisper who they truly want to be in religion. These second period moments helped you find your footing here at SBA, along with your peers.
Girls, get into uniform.
Sorry, miss.
You know the one thing I'm going to miss most about high school and what we're all going to miss most about high school? Is lunchtime. That 40 minutes of freedom it brought us was the best.
That's true. Lunch allowed us to meet up with our friends and tell them all the juicy tea that we just heard from our last class, or to take the time to speed finish the homework for last period. Maybe you were the kids who somehow sat comfortably on the floor of the balcony between the library and the cafeteria.
Or maybe you and your friends would run to Munchies on Wednesdays to get their $5 lunch special, which I'm pretty sure wasn't public health approved, but it didn't matter because it hit the lips regardless.
Yo, maybe you just brought your own microwavable lunch.
But you know what? At some point, I feel like either you begged Sandy for bread or you told her you'd pay her back for a calf cookie. I'm pretty sure I still owe her money.
But then, third period, grade 11.
Catastrophe.
Panic.
Disaster.
Toilet paper shortage. The pandemic really changed our lives. For one, it was the longest March break anyone could remember. And for another, it was the beginning of a whole new world of online learning, fried eyes, and academic dishonesty that we had yet to discover. You didn't hear that from me, though. No matter what we logged into, at the end of the day, our true desire to learn seemed pretty dead.
Though grade 11 didn't offer us all that we expected, we promised to live our last period, grade 12, to the fullest. See, on the surface, school may have seemed like quiet classrooms with letter icons, but we experienced something different. See, our experience was loud and hilarious group chats, Netflix parties, 2 a.m. phone calls that brought great insight.
And finally, being able to see your friends in person during textbook pickup day, made entire quadmasters, and even those pesky daily COVID-19 self-assessment emails worth it. 12th grade also led to some great moments of unforeseen kindness on behalf of our staff, like Among Us marathons, the incredible AP bio prom,
and don't forget the even greater laughs we had in economics class that really lifted our spirits. And who would we be without the spirit wear from all our extracurriculars? Our class sported jerseys from the 2019 and 2020 championship teams, council hoodies, and you can't forget about the unforgettable club tanks.
Playing in the big games, seeing your friends at meetings, hiding the paint stains you made on the floor in the hallways, and even watching your peers take the center stage. These are irreplaceable and unique memories.
They for sure are. But, you know, on the off chance that SBA didn't have a space for you, you made your own. Like the tech girls who were invested in advanced technology and car engineering, or like me, who created A3C, the first Black Student Association at our school.
That was pretty cool, but it's obvious we didn't make it to this point alone. Thank God we got here. Like, seriously, thank you, God. Thank you to our parents, and maybe even our siblings, for being a constant source of love, support, and homework help, no matter what we said during heated dinners. Thank you to our teachers, who have taught us so much more than the curriculum. You always shared your words of wisdom with us, even when you weren't sharing your screens. You allowed us to leave the school better than when we arrived.
And another big thanks goes to our coaches, librarians, supervisors, advisors, and counselors for nurturing our interests beyond the classroom, and for being exemplary role models of the SBA way. And another big shout out goes to our mentors. Thank you for seeing us. For seeing me. The real me. See, we wouldn't have made it without you. And thank you to the administration. And yes, I'm talking about all 5 versions of y'all. Every year there was a new group, but you still supported us regardless.
A shout out to our caretakers for continuing to clean our school daily in spite of a pandemic, religiously rubbing down the doorknobs like their lives depended on it. But you know what? Maybe they did. And lastly, thank you to Sandy and Cafe Andre for all the meals that accompanied each freshly baked whole wheat roll.
Even though we ate our last meal sooner than expected, and the days where we walked the well-kept hallways are over, we are still grateful for all the work put into our school experience.
Yeah, at the end of the day, we are more than just students, and SBA was more than just a pile of bricks. Or rather, 2 piles of bricks separating by a deceivingly large parking lot.
You know what I realized, guys? It was never the place, but always the people. It was us who colored the walls and the doors with paint, us who flavored the halls with tantalizing smells and hospitality, us who made noise and bound in choir, and us who were the soul in our school's body during liturgy. Aisha, I think we forgot to thank the most important group.
Who? Ah, you're right.
Thank you to the class of 2021. It's clear we have a deep-rooted bond and a connection that transcends any virus.
Whether we were locker neighbors, bus buddies, or even accidental schedule stealers, the people we've met have touched our hearts so deeply that Health Canada would shudder at the lack of social distancing.
From long drives to our civilian friend's house to late-night texts, we learned to carry each other through tough times because, you know,
we all need somebody to lean on.
We taught each other that we are never truly alone, and one might even say,
we're all in this together.
From orientation to online learning, our class has been through it all.
We've survived lead water and strikes and lockdowns and vape-induced pipe bursts.
And some seriously unforgettable Regina's fights.
Whatever, Alexis.
Our 4-year grind is undeniable proof that we are resilient and will always be, whether in self-discovery, apprenticeship, college, university, or wherever life takes you.
Just remember, unlike Pfizer or Moderna, life doesn't come in 2 doses. You only have 1 shot, so I hope you take it, not only as a chance to live, but as a chance to live well.
As the last school bell rings, as we read our last weekly newsletter, and as we close our final Google Meets, let's move forward remembering all the good times we had together. Let your ambitions be bigger and better than the vaccine rollout.
And may your future shine bright in the face of all adversity. Ladies, gentlemen, and variations thereupon, please give it up for St. Brother Andre's graduating class of 2021.
And now for a blessing upon our graduates from Father Rick Davis.
Dear St. Brother Andre graduates of 2021, I just wanted to take this opportunity to congratulate you and to wish you all the very best in your future endeavors. It goes without saying that this has been a challenging academic year and not the best of circumstances in which to graduate. But despite all that, I want to encourage you with the same message that I gave to last year's graduates. That is to maintain an attitude of gratitude and to make gratitude a way of life. Because an attitude of gratitude will make life so much more worth living and will make you so much happier people. Because it's almost impossible to be jealous or to be bitter or to be unhappy and to be grateful at the same time. And it's easy to be grateful when things are going well, but it's difficult to be grateful when things aren't going so well. But it's when things aren't going so well that we most need to maintain an attitude of gratitude and to be grateful for all our blessings. Because cultivating an attitude of gratitude doesn't come easy for many of us. And we have to sometimes make a real effort to count our blessings. But again, we will be much happier people when we do that. Because as someone once said, if you focus on what you have in life, you will always have more. But if you focus on what you don't have in life, you'll never have enough. And no pandemic can lock down our ability to be grateful if we choose to count our blessings. And so with that, I would like to now impart a blessing upon each of you. Heavenly Father, we praise you and we give you thanks for all your gifts and for all your blessings. We thank you for the gift of life and the gift of wisdom and of faith. We thank you for the gift of Catholic education and we thank you for the gift of the school community of St. Brother Andre. We thank you for the gift of their graduates. We thank you for all that they have learned this past year and all that they have accomplished. We thank you for all those who contributed to their learning, all the support staff, the volunteers, their teachers, their principals, and their parents. Father, we ask you to continue to pour your blessing upon all these graduates, to fill them with your love, your peace, and your wisdom. As they now embark on a new chapter in their lives, we ask you to guide them in all that they do and all the choices that they make, to grant them success in all their endeavors and to protect them from all harm and from all spiritual, physical, and moral evil. And loving Father, we pray that these graduates, your beloved daughters and sons, will use their knowledge, their skills, and their gifts for your glory and for the good of all people. We ask all this in the name of Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit descend upon each of you and remain with you forever. Amen. So once again, I want to congratulate you, graduates. I wish you all the very best. And remember, an attitude of gratitude will take you far in life. And remember to stay positive, but to test negative. God bless.
Congratulations, class of 2021.
Thank you for joining us for our virtual graduation.
Good night and stay safe.